Just your initial thoughts and what you're expecting from the other banks still to report.
Right. We generally observe relative earnings resilience at the larger state banks. There were signs of stabilizing net interest margins in the fourth quarter. And also a number of banks have reduced their loan loss allowance ratio in the last quarter of the year. So that helped mitigate the net profit decline. And the state banks that have reported financial results so far actually managed to report a small but positive net profit growth for the year.
The sector, though, is certainly not out of the woods yet. What are you expecting in terms of loan growth? Is this likely to slow?
We expect some moderation. In 2020, despite COVID challenges, loans grew about 13%. We're still modeling around 12% loan growth for 2021. But overall, we do expect the profitability pressures to ease amid the economic recovery and also continued financial reform in China, which we think will help mitigate further increases in sector contagion risk.
Grace, you know, we often used to look at non-performing loans as one of the sort of key things to watch out for when these balance sheets were revealed to us. Has that metric changed? And if it has, what else are you looking at in particular to show the health of these institutions?
Yeah, it is one of the leading indicators, but because of the amount of NPL resolutions that banks have undertaken last year, that doesn't always tell us the full picture. For example, the amount of NPLs that were resolved in second half alone was close to 2 trillion RMB compared to about 1.1 trillion recorded in the first half. And that combined compares to 2 trillion for 2019. Now, the banks have guided that they will either keep their NPL resolution more or less stable for 2021. And in some cases, banks have even guided for higher NPL resolution this year. So it feels to us that banks are still actively recognizing and resolving NPLs, which is to us a credit positive sign in terms of how we assess the operating environment in China.
Okay, so with all that in mind, it gives us an idea of what you have in terms of the ratings for the banks. Who's your favorite and who are the ones which need a bit of work?
At the moment, we do have stable ratings for all our Fitch-rated Chinese banks. That's primarily because they're driven by expectations of sovereign support. On a standalone basis, though, we do see some ratings headroom, especially given our view over the operating environment. Issues over data transparency and governance issues in the past have weighed down on our views over the operating environment. But if we look at what regulations I've done it in recent years, we feel that it has worked in containing some of these contagion risks. So overall, we do see some positive developments in the operating environment assessment.
And when it comes to regulations as well, Grace, the crackdown that we're watching on China fintech companies certainly in play too. What sort of impact do you see that on the broader banking sector?
The immediate impact to our rated banks is going to be limited, we think. That's primarily because the non-bank and online lenders mostly cooperate with smaller banks that are outside our ratings coverage. But the whole development in online lending, for example, and tighter regulations around these activities, once again, we feel that that would help address issues around contagion that will help address issues around transparency, because ultimately what the regulations are aiming to do is to improve the overall governance and transparency standards relating to these activities and to also prevent excessive leverage in some of these online players.
And Grace, your thoughts too on expected further tightening from the PBOC and that likely impact here too?
We generally expect the authorities to adopt a prudent monetary stance for 2021. A recent underpinning that is because of capital constraints for the banks in general. Even though we saw a net profit decline moderating, but in most cases, banks are still reporting flat or slight declines in their core capital. And as long as you have banks that are growing faster, than the rate that they're retaining their profits and capital, the core capital still remains under pressure as a whole, and that's going to limit the amount of credit loosening that the banks can undertake.
Now, Grace, you look at the balance sheets of these lenders and you find yourself looking at a very healthy set of figures. I mean, return on equity is pretty good for most of them. We've got good capital tier one ratios and the like. And of course, there's also the dividend for some of them, which is outstanding. And that's been the case for a while. Why have they been so unloved and why are they actually now finding that love?
Well, part of the NPL, the asset deterioration may not have fully surfaced because of relief measures. For example, the State Council's decision to extend some of the loan relief measures until the end of 2021 would mean that some of the bad debts may not have surfaced yet. In terms of dividends, the larger banks have largely guided for a stable dividend payout, but that profit growth still at the single-digit growth type of range, that's still going to limit the upside to dividends.